started with a young woman named Katie Banks. We found her body under a bridge. She'd been living with Carver. She bought him a car, a stereo, and a computer with her family money. And then he shacked up with a woman 15 years older. She ended up dead, but after putting Carver in her will.
And what was the cause of death?
Accidental. At least that's all we could show. This guy is cruel. He gets inside their heads.
So you think it's possible that he drove her to kill herself that made it look like an accident?
It's possible. Then within weeks, he found Helen Harris. Now, Miss Harris was willing to talk to us about the physical and psychological abuse, but she disappeared. And then we got lucky. The building burned down that he had an interest in, and I scoured the scene and I found a heel of a shoe that matched one that I found at his townhouse.
So he slipped up?
The only time. Now, we couldn't get him for what he did to those women, but we were able to put him away for a few years. He was furious, screaming it was a bum rap. It made him nuts that he got caught. Here's our bus.
Got it.
Nice move.
What the?
Somewhere nice and soft to land in.
In the middle of the city?
I think Goose Down or Shaving Cream.
Shaving Cream? You think somebody's gonna have a pile of shaving cream piled up somewhere in the middle of the city?
Right. Brainstorming. Do you have a city map?
There.
All right, I got it here. E4.
All right, we're gonna be coming up into some serious traffic and then a dead end.
Yeah, I see it. Brandon Road. Okay, think, Teach.
Sawdust.
Water. Lake Michigan.
Hold on!
Well done, sir.
Thank you. Now, what are we gonna do when we get to the lake?
Keep going.
Okay, take your time, easy, watch the water. Easy, that's it. Lori?
Ray!
How are you?
I'm all right.
Hey, Benny. I'd like you to meet my first partner, Lori Zahler.
Hi.
Geez, I haven't seen you since you quit the force.
Yeah, well, I pretty much stayed away from all the old places.
The point was a calmer lifestyle, less excitement.
Do you ride this bus every day?
Every day.
At the same time?
Yeah.
Vecchio.
How did you do, Detective?
Did you figure it out by yourself, or did you get help?
You've blown it this time.
Blown it?
No, Detective. Blowing it is for next time.
Well, I'm not saying I won't accompany you, Ray. Obviously, I am accompanying you. I'm just suggesting that you act with restraint, not out of pure emotion.
If I was acting out of pure emotion, I would just kill the guy. So anything you see short of that is a model of restraint.
Well, I remember that.
Detective Vecchio. Well,
violating your parole within hours of being let out? How smart is that? Endangering the lives of 30 individuals and then calling up to take credit for it? How smart is that?
And since you have to register with the parole officer and we're going to know where you are every minute of every day, how smart is that?
Ray, what's he done to you?
He's tutoring me in chemistry.
Pure torture for some.
It's Avogadro's number, Ray. It's standard in any high school chemistry class.
I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
Constable Benton Fraser, Royal Canadian.
Canadian Mounted Police. Yes, I know. I love the Mounties.
Well, thank you.
Don't be thanking him.
Sorry.
There must be some logical explanation for why you're going around on duty with a Chicago policeman.
Curious, possibly, but logical, no.
A refreshing openness? A quality local law enforcement is sorely lacking? I was arrested and convicted for a crime I didn't commit.
Well, there was physical evidence.
False evidence. Could I have been as stupid as they suggest?
You know, Mr. Carver, even the brightest light bulbs burn out.
Indeed. But is it not possible that your friend here crossed the line and framed an innocent man?
That's enough, Carver.
I hope so. And unless the Chicago Police Department has a problem with the teaching of high school science, Shannon and I have a great deal of material to get through.
Save it for someone who cares.
So we're raiding chemistry classes now, huh, Vecchio? Trying to combat this vicious epidemic of people trying to improve their minds in the city of Chicago.
That wasn't the purpose, sir.
Well, good. So there was a reason for you to upset this law-abiding Northside student.
This guy is dirty, Lieutenant. He's out of control. He's going to hurt somebody.
I think it's time to check around and see who is out of control.
All right, fine. Let's put a watch on him.
All right. I'll put a team on it. But you got to nail him for something a little more serious than giving too much homework.
Detective Vecchio's mobile office.
He available?
Yeah.
A full-bore Carver stakeout. I'm impressed, Detective.
Don't be.
This will make for a very solid Carver alibi, now won't it?
Depends on what you're planning.
You're in your car, aren't you, Detective? I'm surprised you let your timing get out of adjustment like that.
Make your move, pal. Let's get this over with tonight.
Good night, socks. Good night, clocks.
Good night, room. And good night, moon.
Yeah.
When you drive your car this morning, you'll find the timing improved.
When a couple of those belts and hoses were shot, so it just made sense to replace them. Basic stuff. Simple maintenance. You should keep on top of this, Detective.